for your attention. So now we are starting the actual application of the cost of capital. As we have already understood that what actually cost of capital is, what is cost of debt, cost of perpetual debt, cost of delivered debt. Again, from the point of view of preference shares, we have studied cost of perpetuity in case of preferential capital, and along with the redeemable capital also, cost of equity we have discussed. We have discussed about cost of retained earnings, and along with all these things, we have also discussed how to calculate weighted average cost of capital, assigning the weights to the various sources of finances. So now here is the part for the Excel application for the cost of capital. So what I would like you to do is just open up your Excel sheets everywhere, and whatsoever the problems you will be doing, particularly we will be starting with the cost of debt, and today itself will be ending with the cost of debt itself. Okay, cost of preference and cost of equity and further things will be done in your Excel, special Excel application class, which will be compulsorily held on every Friday from 4 to 5:30, and you all have to be present over there. And this is not only for ETL power, this will be run for all the MBA at the same slot only. Soon you will receive the this confirmation and all everything from the higher authority. So here we are going to start the cost of debt. Now just let us see this example. What will be the cost of debt KDE if 7 years 15% bonds are sold below par for rupees 94? Now see, KDEs need to be calculated. 7 years debt is there, 15% is the cost of the debt, and but it is presently selling at rupees 94. So what you need to calculate is, you need to calculate the cost of debt here. So this is the Excel sheet where you need to do it. Cost is nothing but the rate at which certain amount or certain things are given or taken from the public. Okay, so just we have to apply the formula for the rate only. So I would like everyone to type this up in your Excel sheets so that we can apply the formula and get the answer. If you need my help, you can just call me upon on the sheet. Particularly the things which are required for this is tax rate, that is the tax income tax rate. Here you will be calculating first the cost of bond before tax and then after the taxes. So tax rate is 35%. Coupon rate, you know about coupon rate? Coupon rate is normal interest rate on which the bonds have been issued, is 15% as given in the question itself. The face value of this particular debenture is 100 rupees. And maturity is for 7 years. After 7 years, it will get mature. Present value is 94 because it is dealing at 94 rupees in the currency market. Now you need to calculate the cost of this bond. So in order to calculate the cost of this bond, we will use the formula rate, particularly rate B5. B5 is 7 because in rate, first most thing is number. When you write equal to rate in bracket, you will get N per. N per is the number of years or number of installment which you need to pay. Second is your PMT. PMT is nothing but the payment of interest. Payment of interest has been calculated by making a product of B3 into B4. B3 is your coupon rate, and this coupon 15% of 100 will be paid. So 15 rupees will come. Likewise over here, if you will multiply B3 into B4 to get PMT. Okay, PV is the present value. It is selling at 94 rupees today accordingly. Future value is FP, that is B6, and has to be taken as minus. Present value is 100 is the present value on which you are just calculating, and B4 again 100, because just a moment. 94. Yeah, of course. Yeah, after that, 94 is the present value. FP is future value is 100 rupees, because when you will be redeeming these debentures, you will get rupees 100. So 100, because debentures are not to be redeemed at premium or at discount. Discount to possible nahi hai. Premium pe नहीं हो सकता, बिकॉज हेयर फेस वैल्यू इज द ऑनली वैल्यू, दिस इज इंक्लूडेड इन द टर्म्स एंड कंडीशंस, एंड अकॉर्डिंग एंड जीरो इज द time because the payment needs to be made after every year. No need to put anything for the guesses. How much you are getting? 16.51%?
17%.
Just correct it with the use of these two. You will get this. Are you getting 16.51?
Yes, sir.
Make the correction for your approximations. You got everyone? Is there anyone who is not getting it? Any problem up till here? Everyone has done it? Right? There is no sound from your class.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now we have to calculate the after tax bond rate. What formula will you apply for it? The formula to be applied for after tax bond rate will be before tax 1 minus T. T is V2. Just apply this formula. V is the cost of bond before tax. You can say this is KB. KB is before tax and KD is after tax. Multiply by 1 minus V2. V2 is your 35% is your tax.
10.7.
How much?
10.70%.
Very good. 10.70% you are getting. So this is the after tax cost of bonds. Okay, this is the way how to calculate the cost of bonds using Excel, or you can say that the Excel application of the bond. Then we proceed further. Fine. There is also an alternative approach to calculate it. Now what is this alternative approach? You can see this example too. X Limited issued debentures with 20 years maturity, 8% a coupon rate and a face value of rupees 100. Okay? If our required rate of return is 10%, how much is the required rate of return?
10%.
And the debenture pays interest semi-annually. Mind it, if you are doing it semi-annually, then your rate gets reduced by half and your payment will be increased by, it will be doubled. Okay? Determine the value of these debentures. So let us must understand what is to be done over here. The semi-annual payment is going to be divided by 2 because total 8% is the coupon rate and you are getting it semi-annually. It means
2 times in a year.
2 times in a year, so you will get rupees 4 2 times, which will make rupees 8, and the required rate of return works out to 5%. Why? Because 10% is the required rate of return. If it will biannually, you will have to just go for 5%, and the period doubles. That's what I have just not told you. For finding out the price of the debentures, the price function will be used. Now here we are using a new function which you have never used before. That is called the price function, and you can write down the price function in your copy. I will explain each and every terminology over here.
Yeah.
Okay, this is the previous one?
Yeah. Sir, this is the 8% coupon rate. Sir, but here how do you know that this is a par annum or semi annum? Sir, because there is nothing written par annum.
Yeah, here it depends on here. Because
this
semi annum.
It is written over there. Sir, sometimes it is not written.
Sometimes it is not written, then the times when it is not written, you can take it annually.
Sir, by
default. Whatsoever is written. No default is there. Whatsoever is written, you have to do as it is. Have you seen the ad of Mountain Dew previously? No. It is clearly mentioned in that ad, but we have to do just opposite of that ad. दिखाओ पे जाओ अपनी अंकल मत लगाओ यहाँ पे करना दिखाओ पे मत जाओ अपनी अंकल लगाओ यहाँ पे दिखाओ पे ही करना है जो दिख रहा है वो करना है अपनी अंकल नहीं लगानी है वट एवर ठीक है सो जो दिख रहा है डू दैट एंड दैट व्हाट इज द फंडामेंटल फॉर लर्निंग फाइनेंस व्हाट सो एवर इज गिवन टू यू यू हैव टू अप्लाई दैट दैट्स एंड इवन इफ यू अप्लाई योर राइट पुट एन असम्प्शन इन जस्ट बिलो द क्वेश्चन दैट आई हैव अज्यूम्ड दिस एंड दिस But such assumption cannot be in a haphazard manner. If something is written over there, you cannot assume it like that. For by default, you are saying it is, if nothing is written, it has to be annually only because interest rates are annual only. Right? So it is mentioned over there. Price, settlement, maturity, rate, YLD. YLD is nothing but the yield. Okay? Redemption, frequency, and basis. These are the points. Let us just have an explanation of these. Have you written this?
No. Let's
just write down this particular formula, and then we will be I will be explaining you that what each and every terminology means and how you can calculate the price of the differentials at that time. Once you have calculated the price, you can calculate the yield also. Okay? Written? Shall I proceed? Fine. So the formula was price, settlement, maturity rate, biyield reduction, frequency and basis, where settlement refers to the date of issue of the debentures. Settlement is the date of settlement, or you can say the date when the things are got settled and the debentures have been issued to the general public. So it is the date of issue of debentures. Maturity is the date on which the last coupon payment is made and the principal is redeemed. It means the difference of these two will give you the time period for which the payment has been, the price is to be calculated. Or you can say the difference between these two will give you MPER in the previous formula. Okay, this is a clear idea. Rate refers to the annual coupon rate. Rate is the annual coupon rate. Previously you have calculated the annual coupon rate, which is actually called the cost of capital for the debenture. Redemption is the amount to be received on maturity. This is the amount which is to be received. For example, in the previous question, what it was? It was rupees 100 because redemption was at par. If the redemption is to be at premium, then the premium amount will be taken as such over here, which will be having impact on the price. Next is your frequency. Frequency will tell you how frequently you are receiving the payment. For example, in this case, you are receiving two times in a year. You are receiving payments two times in a year. So accordingly, the frequency will be 2 over here. Basis describes the assumption regarding the number of days in a month and a year. Because see, you are using settlement and maturity. There will be varied number of days when leap year comes. So on an average, if we are assuming there are 30 days in a month and 365 days in a year, then we have to use 0 over here as a basis. If we will change the basis from 0 to 1, 1 is having some other meaning, that might be 30 days in a month and 366 days in a year, or 360 days. Accordingly, the basis will change. But by default, the basis has to be 0, which is applicable and acceptable everywhere. Okay, I hope you have understood. One thing is missing over here, that is YLD. YLD is nothing but the expected return. Okay, the expected return which you are actually expecting. Right, so let us go on the Excel sheets. Just do it. You have to write the issue date, maturity rate, expected return, coupon rate, maturity value in this all, because these all are the variables which need to be present up till basis. Then we will calculate the value of the debenture afterwards. Now here you have to put the date. When you will put it in this format, it will automatically, this cell will automatically will change into the date format. Okay? After putting date over here, see the word what format it is coming up. Okay, it will automatically come in date format. Now the maturity period is 20 years. So you have to add 20 years in this date in order to arrive the maturity date. Instead of calculating it manually, you can do it. Plus 20 into 365. We are assuming that there are 365 days in a year.